things, and the Lord of Lords, we thank you once more for the dawn of a new day. We thank you as a wonderful family.
Father,
we thank you for the life. We thank you for protections. We thank you for providing.
Father,
let your name be glorified again today by this gathering.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
I take away any evil gathering in this place.
Oh, yes.
Wherever they have gathered to plug your miracle, let that gathering catch fire.
Fire!
Wherever they have gathered to plug your prophecy, let that gathering catch fire.
Fire!
In the air.
Fire!
The land.
Fire!
The sea.
Amen.
Put your hands together for Pastor Jesus as you take your seat on the head of your enemies. Healing, prophetic, and deliverance service.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
And I believe a lot of people are going back with miracle today. But I'm talking to you, shout yes.
Yes.
If you will be the one to go with a miracle, shout yes.
Yes.
If you know that you have not wasted time to come here, shout yes.
Yes.
I want us to quickly turn to the book of Daniel. Very old story we know. In the book of Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3. Because of time, we'll start reading from verse 22. And we'll end at verse 38. Watching us direct. Distance is no barrier with my God. The miracle you are looking for will also meet you there in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So turn to Daniel chapter 3, verse 22 to 30. I'll be using the New King James Version. 22 says, therefore, because the king's command fire killed those men who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Fiery furnace. Nebuchadnezzar was astonished, and he rose through, O king, in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. Then Nebuchadnezzar went near the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spoke, saying, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out and come here. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came from the midst of his counselors, gathered together, and they saw this man on whose bodies the fire had no power. The hair of their head was not stained, nor were their garments affected, and the smell of the fire was not on them. Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel and delivered his servants who trust in him, and they have frustrated the king's word and yielded the bodies that should not serve nor worship any god except their own God. Therefore, I make a decree that any people, nation, or language which speak anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut into pieces, and their houses shall be made and ash her, because there is no God, no other God, who can deliver like this. Then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the province of Babylon. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
I title the message of today, Coming Out Better. Tell two people, coming out better.
Coming out better.
Coming out better.
I thought the message title is a prophecy to somebody.
Let me see.
Say somebody, coming out better.
Coming out better.
I am coming out of the challenge better.
I am coming out of the challenge better.
Spirit of the living God, fall flesh on your words, that I may not speak with man's unenlightened wisdom, but let me speak under the unction of the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
I disappear that you may appear in this place. They are coming out of any challenge better in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I cover this message with the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Yeah. When you look at this story, there is something you will understand here very clear, that the promotion came only after they have gone through the challenge.
We hear you, Daddy.
The king respected their God only after the fire was unable to burn them. Am I talking to somebody? Am I talking to somebody?
Preach, Daddy.
People will respect your God after today. The God you've been serving for long, they will respect your God after today. The kingdom of darkness will respect your God. Even when we put ourselves into problems, God does not want us to look like what we have been through. Even in your mistakes, that you are going through some challenges today, that you put yourself in that challenge because of the mistake you made. God does not want you to come out the same way you went through that challenge. He will want you to come out better than you went into that challenge. I prophesy to two people today.
Now receive.
You are coming out better. Challenge, you will not look like what you have gone through. In fact, people will look at you, they will not know what you have gone through. Because you are not looking like what you have been through. Who am I talking to?
I am the one.
Who am I talking to?
I am the one.
Who am I talking to?
I am the one.
We all get to a moment that we are disappointed. And we seem not to understand the life we are living in. There are times when you go through life, you are even serving God, but when you look at the things that are frustrated, at times life is not fair at all. No matter how you pray, no matter. Prayer you pray is like you have not prayed enough. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, Daddy.
Am I talking to somebody?
Oh, yes, sir.
Sometimes we are in serious difficulties. But when God wants to restore you, you are not going to look like what you have been through in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When God will be about to restore you, or when it's your people will not recognize you again. The same people that when you were going through, you were like you can beg but from these people before you leave. You were like you needed but their support. People were in the fire. King Nebuchadnezzar was like, I am the only voice that can speak. I am the one that has authority over you. There is nobody that can have authority over you now. But unknown to Nebuchadnezzar, there was a God that when he says yes, nobody can say no. And he was just looking. Indeed, he made the fire not to touch their clothes. They were not hurt by the fire. They said they came out, their traces were not affected by the fire. They said even the smell, you could not get the smell of the fire on them. But they were from the fire. That is coming out better. Coming out of a challenge and nobody know that you were in a challenge. I prophesy to two people here.
Now we see.
Fears all over the world.
Oh yes.
You are coming out of that challenge breaker in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When he said they came out, there was not even a smell of the smoke of them. Mean that they came out not looking like somebody that has been in fire.
Fire, sir.
Yeah.
We hear you, Daddy.
That there was no evidence to show that they have been through what they went through.
Oh, yes.
When you will come out,
oh, yes.
People will not know what you have gone through.
Oh, yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not look like what you have gone through. You know, God does not just want you to come out of a challenge.
Amen.
No. God wants that when you are coming out of the challenge, by his hand,
oh, yes.
There is evidence.
Oh, yes.
The hand of God touches you, it leaves a mark.
Right on, sir.
I say it leaves a mark.
Right on, sir.
A mark will be left on somebody today.
I am the one.
That as you are coming out of that challenge,
yeah.
People will see a mark of God on you.
I will see.
And they will give you respect and promotion.
I will see.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are we see there?
Right on, sir.
Are we see there?
Oh, yes.
Are we see there?
Much fire, Daddy.
So neighbor, nobody will be able.
Nobody will be able
to tell.
To tell
what you have been through.
What you have been through. We hear you, Daddy.
The challenge may look very difficult. It may look very tough. Life may seem to be unfair. But when God will bring you out of that difficulties, nobody will be able to tell what you've been through.
Why don't sir?
Because there will be no mark, there will be no smell.
Oh, yes.
The problem has not affected your color. It has not affected your beauty.
Oh, yes.
It has not affected your relationship. Because God is with you in that challenge.
Oh, yes.
Many others went through that, not up to half of that challenge, they died.
Right now, sir.
You are not hearing me.
We hear you, Daddy.
They did not even win 1/4 of the challenge, they died. What is keeping you to go till the end? It's God that is surrounding you in that challenge.
Oh, yes.
So, tell two people, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Don't stay on the disappointment.
Don't stay on the disappointment.
Jesus. If I were you, I would shout yes.
Yes.
Say neighbor.
Neighbor,
God is going to bring me out.
God is going to bring me out
better than I went in.
Better than I went in.
Nobody will know what you went into.
Amen.
Nobody will know what you went through.
Oh, yes.
What the challenge was. And when God takes you out of a challenge, a lot of people will be able to see the testimony that He has put into your mouth.
Yes.
He put a testimony in the mouth of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Oh, yes.
See, today we are testifying
right now, sir.
Because of that story.
Oh, yes.
Today we are reading their testimonies. Let this message put a testimony in your mouth in the name of Jesus.
Now we see.
Let this message encourage you so that you will have your own testimony.
Oh, yes.
What the challenge took out of you, my God is about to bring it back.
Now we see.
Maybe the challenge took away your respect. You know, you can be in a challenge until nobody is respecting you.
Right now, sir.
I mean, people who are not supposed to talk with you, they start to talk to you.
Right now, sir.
People who are not supposed to sit with you, they command you to sit down. Even in the family meeting, they don't want you to make a point.
Very correct, sir.
Are you hearing me?
You are preaching, Daddy.
The ones that are supposed to.
Right now, sir.
They cannot listen to you. They cannot respect you again. They are not taking your position and giving to your younger brother. But I came to tell somebody today.
Oh, yes.
I say I came to. Because of difficulty, they could not respect you again.
Right now, sir.
When God brings you out better. They will even respect you more than they respected you before.
Now we see.
When you want to give your own point, they will not listen. You say, sit down. Ah, people are talking, you too, you are talking. And the point you are making is going to help everybody. Mm. But they don't see you again.
Why not, sir?
Because your small brother or your small sister is abroad. They say, let that one talk. Even if he's talking foolish, they'll say, we hear you, man. Mm.
Thank you.
They say, we hear where you're on. You have made the best point. Mm. Because why? They know that that one can help them financially.
Right, no, sir.
But I came to tell somebody today.
Oh, yes.
The only help that will last is the help that comes from Jehovah.
Oh, yes.
The only promotion that lasts is your position today. Mm. But if God brings restoration to you, they will respect you back more than before.
Oh, yes, sir.
I see two people here.
Yeah.
Your respect is coming back in the name of Jesus.
Now we see.
They are not hearing me.
We hear you, Daddy. You are preaching, my father.
I took the wrong class.
I am coming back.
Don't be respected of man. Mm. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, Daddy.
When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had a decree that the king has already said that everybody should bow down to the image made by the king, they said, we will not. They support them all.
Oh, yes.
You can go in a family of seven children. Eh?
Find yourself.
Four, they are supporting the wrong side. Three, they are supporting the right person. The family is already divided into two.
Right now, sir.
Why are not supporting the one that are supporting the other one is because there is. Am I talking to somebody?
Oh, yes, sir.
Because of food. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said, no, we cannot support the wrong. We cannot bow down to this image. We will continue to bow down to God.
Oh, yes.
There is a Shadrach, there is a Meshach, and there is an Abednego. In that fire, we better die in that fire. That is the statement they made in front of the king.
Yes.
Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, Daddy.
Are you bold enough to tell people the truth, even if you are going to die?
Yes, sir.
Are you bold enough as a child of God to tell your family the truth, even if you are to tell the truth and die and they reject you? Are you ready to follow God to the point where they say this is dead? And if you continue to follow God, they will kill you. Can you follow God to that point where you say you prefer to die with your God?
Yes.
You are a Shadrach.
Amen.
You are an Abednego.
Amen.
You are a Meshach.
Amen.
That is the example they set for us.
Oh, yes.
That is the example they set for us. One day, death will still take you.
Right now, sir.
Why not die with Jesus? There are people that comprehend their faith because of small food. There are people that comprehend their faith. And you don't know anything, doctor. That virus. If they could respect the Bible like this, the word of God like this, the whole world will be transformed.
Right now, sir.
They say, wash us, everybody wash us. But the word of God, they don't want to follow.
Right now, sir.
I say, if people can respect the word of God the way they are respecting man's order, the minister's order, many people when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused in front of the king, God was knocking and said that these are my boys. They have told the king the truth. They have stood on their stone. And until the point where they sit now, carry them. and threw them in the fire. God was waiting to hear if by the time they had received the fire, they said, no, we worship the real God. And they said, we'll enter the fire. When the people that carried them to put into the fire were about to throw them in the fire, fire caught them that carried Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and burned them. Now, what happened is that God has gone ahead when they were still making the plans, trying to burn Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. An angel had already gone ahead.
Oh, yes.
When the angel went ahead, he entered the fire. When they were bringing Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, he allowed the fire to burn those who carried Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego entered the fire, there was no fire at all. The angel became what? It came what?
Air conditioner.
For you.
I receive.
I say it's in your fire with you.
I receive.
He said, the king said, ah. He called the counselors. Did we not bound three men and throw into this fire? But I am not seeing the fourth one. And they are walking inside the fire, walking freely. And the fourth one looks like the Son of God. Jesus.
Preach that now.
My question here is, why was it that the same person that asked them to throw in the fire was the one seeing the angels? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did not see the angels.
My dear sir.
Yeah.
You are preaching, my father.
You may be going to know where you are going without seeing an angel around you.
My dear sir.
But the enemies around your life, they are seeing the angel that is going with you.
Oh, yes. You are preaching.
That is why I was complaining. That, oh, this difficulty that I'm going through. Not knowing that there is somebody looking at you, that if I cannot reach that level, if I may just reach that level,
right, sir,
I have arrived.
Amen.
After today, you are coming out better.
Now receive.
I say you are coming out better.
Now receive.
I say you are coming out better.
I receive.
Stop complaining. Don't stay on the disappointment. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did not complain anyway. As they were carrying him to the fire. Complaining is already telling the enemy that this promotion. You can never see promotion when you stay on the disappointment.
True, sir.
I prophesy.
Now receive.
You are coming out better in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever challenge you have been through,
oh yes,
people will not know you again.
Oh.
Jesus is about to put an end. People will be unable to tell you to tell what you have been through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Understand and stay on the principles of God.
Amen.
When you be in that fire, the fire will not burn you. Amen. My own fire or the other in life.
Right, sir.
Mean that if I believe God and I trust in God, even if the coronavirus enters me, I know that my God will remove it. If I'm talking to you, shout yes.
Yes!
I don't know the fire you are going through. Mm. My God says, fear not.
Amen.
He says, fear not.
Amen.
He says, fear not.
Amen.
God will supernaturally bring you out of that fire.
Amen.
In a supernatural way, he will bring you out of that fire. He will not bring you out of that fire in a normal way.
Mm.
If you want to follow the normal way, the way the world brings solution to problem, you are not going to come out of that problem.
Right, yes, sir.
But if you go with God, he will bring a supernatural method, a method that has never been tested on earth, a weapon that does not exist on earth. Heavenly weapon are able to take away any problems. So, you are coming out better.
I will see.
All I know is you are coming out better than you went into that problem.
Amen.
When Joseph was in prison, the Bible says Joseph was hated by his own brothers. They sold Joseph out. Joseph finally landed in the house of Potiphar. The wife of Potiphar wanted to lay with Joseph. Because he refused, he was thrown into the prison because of the life of his wife. While in prison, that was a fire Joseph was going through. That he's been put into prison for what he has not done. Some of you are going through problems that you don't even know, you don't understand where the problem came from. It did not cry. It did not stay on the disappointment. He still continued to pray to God. He continued to interpret dreams. He continued to use the gift of God in him in order to glorify the name of God. When you are in problem, check at what God has given you. Check at the talent you have. To promote you.
Now we see.
It's about to change your life.
Now we see.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus did not stay quiet.
Oh, yes.
Are we still there?
Right now, sir.
Are we still there?
What you part
are we still there?
Oh, yes, sir.
So never.
Neighbor.
Nobody.
Nobody.
Would know what.
Would know what.
You have been through.
You have been through.
Do you know that even in imprisonment may be to kill?
Oh, yes.
He started interpreting dreams in the prison. And before you know it, this key made a way for
no.
I am not empty.
I am.
God will only make a way when there is no way.
Right. Yes, sir.
But if you walk in life and you say, Father, lead me, rule me. But also say, Father, show me the way.
Quiet on, sir.
God will make a way when there seems to be
a way.
through.
I receive. Yes.
Am I talking to someone?
Oh yes, sir.
When Joseph. In the book of Genesis chapter 42,
yes,
Joseph recognized his brother.
Right, yes, sir.
When you were. When he was in dark, by the time he met the brothers, the anointing from preaching, from what he has gone through, made Joseph to look lighter.
Right, yes, sir.
When he anointing is strong, that olive oil is taken from a tree called olive. Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, daddy.
And for the oil to come out, well, then it becomes an ocean tomorrow. The problem you are going through, you are passing through a process.
Oh, yes.
In order to be is that don't stay on the disappointment. Look at how you will come. Stay on the challenge, you cannot come out.
What I am going through. Right, yes, sir.
Many pretend to love you, but when you are in challenge, they will run away from you.
Right, yes, sir. Right, yes,
sir. The ones that really love you, can I talk to somebody?
Talk to me, my father.
Have you sat sometimes like this in your life and you look at the people and you think that man does not pick your call?
Right, yes, sir.
You do everything, he's not picking your. There's no way.
Yes.
And that's somebody you have helped. That's somebody you are hoping. That's somebody you trust. But when you are down, God to let you know that He is all in you. God.
Oh, yes.
Not the people you trust in, but trust in God, and God will bring you trustful people.
Amen. We hear you, Daddy.
To make us to see you. But let me
bring. My father,
God has given Joseph.
They threw him, sold him.
But God, make the king to recognize you. To become a prime minister in Cameroon, you must first of all be a citizen of this country.
Right, yes, sir.
To become a prime minister in Cameroon, you must first of all be, you must have been in government. To somebody.
Oh, yes, sir.
But I did not hear anywhere in the Bible. He wants to promote you. It does not matter your background. It does not matter your education.
Right, yes, sir.
It does not matter. After today, you are coming out better.
Now receive.
Build your church.
God will make a way.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when he had come to his senses, he said, what am I doing here? My father has more than enough.
Mm.
There are people working under my father.
Mm.
It's better I go back. Are we still together?
Right on, sir.
And when he made that decision, he went back. The father welcomed him. And when he had taken that decision, he came out better.
Right on, sir.
Because there was a celebration when he came back. But when he was leaving the father, I did not hear celebration.
Right on, sir.
Ay.
He was preaching that day.
But when he came back, there was a celebration. For the rest, you will go looking for the one. God does not want you to lose. God wants to wake up you this morning.
Hallelujah.
So that you will be the one to make you come back. Not only coming back, but coming back better than you were.
Okay.
Am I talking to somebody?
Talk to me, daddy.
Am I talking to somebody?
Oh, yes, sir.
The prodigal son came back better. The problem with many people is failing to come back to their senses. To know that I have struggled on my own, only God can make me become what I am supposed to be. Failing to know that the one that created the universe out of nothing, the one that spoke words into existence, the one that said, let there be light, and there was light.
Oh, yes.
The one that when he says yes, nobody can say no. The one is waiting for somebody today.
I am the
one. May you make a decision in your heart. What he made you to. Your mind by the reason of this message.
Oh yes.
Let it be catching fire right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anytime you have your money, thinking that you still have a position, thinking that you still have this or that, let that power be paralyzed today.
Be paralyzed.
Let your eyes be open.
Oh yes.
To see what God can do in your life.
Oh yes.
Let your eyes be open.
Hey.
To see the one that is sitting on the throne. Are you going to get back what you have lost? The problem is, number one, recognizing, coming back to your senses, recognizing your source. And don't depend on the resources around your life.
Find yourself.
People still depend on people. On men. Man will fail you.
Right on, sir.
I say man will fail you.
You are preaching that thing.
But your God will never fail you.
Oh, yes, sir.
He said, I am not a man that I should die, that I should lie. Have I said it? Will I not do it? He wants to do it in the life of somebody here today.
I am the one.
He's a father. Embrace God fully. They are not yet born again children of God. They are still coming to church like they are going to the market. They are still reading their Bible like they are reading a novel, a literature. Or history book. It is time. High time. This is end time. End time is nearer. When you start to see the signs of war everywhere, diseases everywhere that the Bible had already said, you must come back to your senses.
Oh, yes.
To embrace your God. That even if I am dying today, let me die with God.
Oh yes. Bring it on, daddy.
And the prodigal son came out better. He was no longer, when he came back to the father, he was no longer come back to God fully. Not on worshiping God like the one in solution. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did not worship God for a solution.
Right on, sir.
But in the course of worshiping God, solution came.
Right on, sir.
In the course of trusting God by faith with their heart, solution came.
Oh, yes.
Don't go to God like you are not going to ask for solution. Go to God like you love God. Even when there is nothing. Go to God like there is nothing that can separate you from the love of God. Money will not separate you from the love of God. Sickness will not separate you from the love of God. Coronavirus has separated you from the love of God.
Right on, sir.
They can no longer go to church again. And the Bible says, what can separate you from the love of God? Is it sickness? Is it death? Because even if I die physically, before dying, I am connected with God. The Bible says, if the spirit of him that rose Jesus from the dead lives in you, that same spirit will vitalize your mortal body.
Right,
so even if I die this physical day, Before dying, I am connected with God. I will rise up one day to see him face to face.
Oh, yes.
If that is in your mind, after today, you are coming out better.
Have you seen?
I say you are coming back better.
Have you seen?
All what you lost, God is about to give you back. Your position in God. The things you're supposed to do on earth. The illnesses. When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were undergoing through their process and they were about to put them in fire, they did not complain. They were only going to enter that fire. And when they had entered it, God said, you will pass through fire and fire will not burn you.
Oh, yes.
And truly the fire did not burn them. Any kind of fire you are going through, I declare to you, that is not the end of your life.
Right, yes, sir.
Let them say what they want to say, but at the end of the day, there shall be promotion. I said there shall be promotion.
Oh, yes.
I said there shall be promotion.
Oh, yes.
There shall be promotion.
Oh, yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Of this challenge.
Of this challenge.
People will not recognize me.
People will not recognize me.
Who is coming out of that challenge?
I am the one.
Who is coming out of that challenge?
I am the one.
Who is coming out of that challenge?
I am the one.
In God. Brought Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego out of that challenge. He is still on the throne.
Oh, yes.
If he brought the madman and gathered in the book of Luke, where legions of demons were in this man, bound in the morning, this man. And he knew that there were demons in him. He asked us a question, who are you? When the demon saw Jesus, they started trembling. That have you come to take us out of this place when it is not in our time? But if you must take us out, let us enter in the head of shrines. And Jesus said, who are you? He said, we are legends. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When this man finally was delivered from these demons, at the end of that chapter, the Bible says, hallelujah.
Amen.
God is about to dress somebody today.
I am the one
that is coming out. I am coming out better.
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 For now, whatever
challenge you talk today,
let there be fire right now.
Fire.
Whatever. So whatsoever challenge. Of the smoke
on me. I am coming out better. I am coming. Oh yes.
I take my mind. As I pray now.
As I pray now.
I take it back.
I take it back.
I take it back.
I take it back. The child of God. I take it back. In my life,
what are you still waiting?
What are you still waiting?
The rooster right now.
The rooster right now.
Say, oh God of glory,
oh, pray.
in your tree. What do you see? Some of you carry baby on your back. Well, you don't have you right now.
Come out.
Oh, God of glory.
Oh, God of glory.
What do you not do it?
Let me not do it.
Controlling your dream land.
Right on,
you see yourself with dead people. Mm. People that have died. Mm. You see you eating with them. Mm. You see you in evil catching. So from God is now controlled by a power. Mm. That power is catching fire to you.
Fire!
To any power!
Any power!
Controlling my dream land.
Controlling my dream land.
Let that power.
Let that power.
Catch fire. Who is ready?